Dear students, today we will be studying a microfiltration module. So here we can see a microfiltration plant. So let us go to this plant and see what is there. So this is the balance tank. So in this we will be feeding our feed material here. So we can see at the bottom side we are having a cross type of fitting. It is just to prevent any extraneous matter if present. Then at the bottom of this we can see there is a valve. So this valve will be feeding this material to this centrifugal pump. So this centrifugal pump is sucking the feed and then discharging it via this particular pipeline to this side. So this side we are having a membrane module. Let us see from the other side. So this is the membrane module to which this valve has sent its material. So in this membrane module we are seeing a tubular kind of membrane in which we are having this long cylindrical tubular pipeline in which the membrane is housed. This particular connection here, this is on the retentate side, and in this particular membrane another connection at this top side is also on the retentate side, and at this side on this top we are having this permeate outlet. So we can see there is a rotameter here. So this rotameter will be indicating the flow rate, and after this rotameter this pipeline is continuing to this point here, and then it can be controlled by using this particular valve, and it can be then directed by this pipeline here to this side, and then can be suitably collected in a container at this side. Now coming on to the permeate side, this is the permeate side. We are having two sides, one at this top, another at this bottom, and these sides are connected by this centrifugal, another centrifugal pump here. So this centrifugal pump, what it is doing is, it is sucking the permeate from this side and recirculating it back via this connection to this side back again. So by recirculating the permeate back into the system, it is maintaining a constant transmembrane pressure so as to avoid choking or blocking of membrane pores. At another side, on the discharge end of this discharge line of the pump only, we can see this pump, its discharge line coming up to here, and at this T junction, after this T junction, we are having this rotameter, and then permeate also can be removed via flow control valve here, via this pipeline, and it can be recirculated back, or we can open this union and then redirect this pipeline elsewhere to have this collected. Or we have one more option at this side of the valve. We can supply one more pipeline at this end and the permeate can be suitably collected. Now this is the pressure gauge. So this pressure gauge will be measuring the pressure on the retentate side. Here we can see this is connected to this side, retentate side. So this is the same pressure gauge, and this pressure gauge as well as this pressure gauge, these are on the permeate side. So this permeate side's pressure is required to be maintained, to maintain that constant transmembrane pressure. At the retentate side, here we are seeing at the discharge end, this is the pressure gauge. At the suction end, this is another pressure gauge. And this centrifugal pump, one more centrifugal pump here. So this is circulating this permeate. On the retentate side, we are having this centrifugal pump here. So this is also required or used to maintain that constant transmembrane pressure. So by controlling the flow rates on this feed or retentate side as well as permeate side, we can maintain a constant transmembrane pressure. So here we are seeing the recirculation loop of this pump. So it is sucking at this lower end here, then discharging via this pipeline. This is an heat exchanger, basically a tubular type of heat exchanger, tube in tube type, and it is coming back to this side here. So we can see that we can have a recirculation at this via this loop at this end. These connection here as well as here are for this heat exchanger. So this is the incoming line. So here we can see this pipeline, this flexible pipeline, which is connected to this manifold here. So this is a steam and water line here at this end. And then at the discharge side, this pipeline is emerging out from this another flexible hose, and it can be then drained or suitably recirculated. This is its control panel. So here we can see on off switches of those three pumps are located at this end. So this is a microfiltration plant.